Hello, folks. I'm back. I was sick for a little while, but now I'm feeling better. Couldn't really make these pouring videos when I was coughing. So, I'm going to attempt another four elements pour. This time, I'm doing it on a little bit of a smaller canvas. Going to do it's a 10 by 20, so a little bit smaller. Hopefully, I'll get a little more control with this one. Because I'm going to be doing something a lot riskier. See, I'm going to be doing just two flip cups. I'm going to do the spiral pour for the air, flip cup for the ocean, flip cup for earth, and then going to try and pour fire by doing a few stripes and then swiping. So, just for save some time, pre-pour the flip cups. And got the spiral pour ready, just blue and white for the air. And here comes the hard part. This is what's gonna make or break this pour. Red's a little bit thicker than I would've liked, but don't really have time to go back now. So we're just gonna give it a generous pour because a lot of this is probably gonna slide off the edge. So I got my regular stock red. Got the glow-in-the-dark orange that I love, that you guys know I love. Put it in all my paintings so that maybe Martha Stewart can give me an endorsement for plugging her paints so much. Glow-in-the-dark yellow. That's going to be what I'm swiping over. So, that going there. Got lots of paper towels off of the side to swipe with. Hard to wipe my hands with. And here's the second hardest part. You know what? I feel like I should swipe a little. Let me swipe a little bit before. Let's go smaller. I'll swipe a little bit. Yeah, just to make sure we get a little bit of the fire effect before these paints start bumping into each other. Too crazy right now because I might have to redo these depending on how the paints mix. Still want it a little bit thick so the fire doesn't get eaten up by the other pours and the flip cups. Cut into it too much, but at the same time, I want it to kind of blend in there. Hopefully they'll give us enough of a fiery look. Now this one I'm using Dixie cup for the spiral pour. little bit of a smaller lip to the cup. Plastic cups, for whatever reason, just don't want to what's the word I'm looking for? It's like you can't control it as much out of the plastic. I mean, they're great for flip cups, but if you want to get this like a little more precision in your pour, I gotta recommend the Dixie cups. Well, they're getting harder to find these days. I don't have them at my supermarket. You only have the little ones at the Walmarts now. So if you got a great place to find the Dixie cups the size I'm using right now, please post that in the comments. I could definitely appreciate it. So once we start tilting this guy, so hopefully stretch out and look like sort of wispy clouds going through a blue sky. You know, it's starting to scare me doing that. Overdo the sky. I won't have to stretch this too much. So hopefully this will just give me enough leadway to tilt it without having to dump all the fire off. That's kind of my big fear here. And what I'm kind of hoping is that the flip cups will help push that in a little bit. Okay, here come the scary parts. So, here we go. Earth pour flip cup. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. Since it's already spilled a bit, I can probably walk it over. One. So luckily the flip cups are a little more fluid. Sorry to be showing you the back of the canvas there. Get this completely covered. And unfortunately, I didn't have big enough space to put this on. And, of course, I forgot to buy gloves again, so. Okay, let me get a lot of paint off my hand, and then we can do some little touch-ups. And I'll bring you in for a close-up of this one, which so far I'm pretty happy with. Yeah, I like these. The idea of the elemental pour, trying to do earth, wind, fire, water, or I guess we call it an avatar pour if you're into Avatar The Last Airbender or Legend of Korra. Two of my favorite cartoons. Okay, that looks pretty good. Get that the way I want it. A little more paint off my hands before I grab the camera. Okay, ready for the close-up. Nice little bit of water. So, want to get the swipe in. So, yeah, I kind of like that. The only thing I don't like is that little bit of green. Yellow and blue makes green, so gotta be careful with that next time. And probably could have used a little less white. Gotta be more sparse with that. You know, interesting blend into the earth. So using metallic copper and gold and black paints and a little bit of red there. And if you want to see this when it's dry, you can go to my Instagram page, Darth Prozac. So Instagram.com/DarthProzac. And you can see how this dried. Thank you and have a good day or night.